become a portal for a variety of entertainment options. So why do all of this for a fit?
We used to call it penalty box because subcompact was, I'm going to get this car because this is all the only I can afford. Nowadays, it's totally different. People are shopping for the subcompact aggressively because we have more feature content. Exterior, interior is being extremely refined. So the segment itself is growing and being matured. So that's why we needed to make sure that we have a very good vehicle in this segment.
Yet the upgrades did not add weight, and performance is better thanks to a more powerful 1.5-liter aluminum alloy four-cylinder engine. Horsepower is up to 130, and the block can deliver 114 foot-pounds of torque, which takes it from being an underpowered vehicle to something much more confident in all traffic conditions. EPA fuel economy ratings are better, and even with the changes, the Fit is rated cleaner at a ULEV level 3. Eventually, we might see a hybrid version, which is already sold in Japan. Despite the power upgrades, we noticed interior operating noises lower than the previous model. Part of that is attributable to a change in transmissions. A CVT has replaced the previous 5-speed automatic, while a 6-speed manual is still available for those who want one. Interior fit and finish has also stepped up from the expected plastic hard surfaces. And when it comes to considering space, Honda makes its name in the compact segment, the improvements for 2015 are not surprising. However, to remain competitive in the segment, the design and engineering team will have to be a little more aggressive in adding new features if the brand wants to keep ahead of the competition. This is Greg Morrison.
We want to know what you think, so email us. The address is bumpertobumpertv@cs.com.